This topic is current, voltage, and resistance.
这个主题是电流、电压和电阻。
When there is an electric potential difference in between two points in a conductor, the electrical charge will flow from higher potential point to lower potential point. The flow of electrical charge makes up the electrical current on the conductor. The conclusion is, electric potential difference make up the current in conductor.
当导体的两点之间存在电势差时，电荷将从高电位点流向低电位点。电荷的流动形成了导体上的电流。结论是，电势差形成了导体上的电流。
The phenomena of electric charges flow from one point to another point due to the potential difference that has applied to the two point can be understood through the concept of electric current, voltage, and resistance.
施加到两个点的电位失差导致了电荷从一个点流到另一个点的现象。这现象可以通过电流、电压和电阻的概念得到理解。
The current, voltage, and resistance are the three important parameters to describe the phenomena of moving charges in the conductor.
电流、电压和电阻是三个重要参数。它们描述了导体中电荷移动的现象。
The concepts of voltage, current, and resistance are difficult to understand because we cannot see them. To have a better understand the concept, we may use an analogy. When describing voltage, current, and resistance, a common analogy is a water tank. The condition of water and water flow from the tank is the phenomena that can be seen.
电压、电流和电阻的概念会很难理解，因为我们无法看到它们。为了更好地理解这个概念，我们可使用类比。描述电压、电流和电阻常见的类比是水箱。在此，在水箱中，水流动情况可以被看到。
In this analogy,
在此类比中
The analogy of charge is water amount in the water tank.
电荷的类比是水箱中的水量。
The analogy of voltage is the water pressure.
电压的类比是水压。
The analogy of current is the water flow.
电流的类比是水流。
The analogy of resistance is the hose width of the water tank.
电阻的类比是水箱的管道宽度。
We may try to answer this question for our understanding about the concept. Why there is a water flow from the water tank? Because water is reserved at higher position in water tank, this causes the water pressure. Water pressure is the physical quantity that causes the water flow.
我们可尝试回答这个问题，以便我们对此概念有所了解。首先，为什么水箱中会有水流动？因为水被保留在水箱中较高的位置，因此会引起水压。水压是导致水流的物理量。
Same to the current in a circuit. Why there is an electric current in a circuit?
这与电路中的电流相同。为什么在电路中会有电流呢？
Because charges are accumulated in the electric source. And this causes the potential difference.
这是因为电荷累积在电源中，这会导致电位差。
What happens if more water is added into the water tank?
如果在水箱中添加了更多的水，情况会怎样？
The answer is, the water pressure increase, and water flow will be faster.
答案是，水压升高，水流更快。
What happens if the more charges is added in the power source of circuit?
如果在电路电源中添加更多电荷，会发生什么情况？
The potential difference increase, and current will be increase.
这时，电位差将增加，电流也将增加。
This topic, we will go to the detail of voltage.
这个主题中，我们将详细介绍电压。
Voltage is the electric potential difference between two points in a conductor or circuit. For example, the two points are the point 1 and point 2 in the circuit. And the potential difference between the two points, point 1 and point 2, can be gained by minus the potential in point 1 with the potential in point 2. This is minus V1 with V2. The positive terminal, which represented by a longer bar, will have higher potential. Then, the negative terminal, which represented by shorter bar. In our daily life, for example, when the 2A battery is said to have 1.5V. This 1.5V is actually gained by minus the potential in positive terminal with potential in negative terminal.
电压是导体或电路中两点之间的电位差。例如，两个点在电路中的点一和点二，以及点一和点二这两个点之间的电位差，可以通过点一的电势和点二的电势相减获得。这是 V 一减以 V 二。正极端子它具有比负极端更高的电位。正极用长条来表示，负极用较短的条来表示。在我们的日常生活中，例如 2A 电池有 1.5 伏特的电压。这个 1.5 伏特实际上是通过正极的电势减去负极的电势而获得。
The analogy of voltage is the water pressure in a water tank. The net pressure in the water system is the pressure in tank A minus with pressure in tank B.
电压的类比是水箱中的水压。水系统中的静压力是水箱 A 中的压力减去水箱 B 中的压力。
The water pressure in a water tank can be increased by adding more water to the water tank or installing a water pump. For example, when add more water in tank A, will increase the net pressure in the water system.
水箱中的水压可以通过添加更多的水或安装了水泵来增加水箱中的水压。例如，当在水箱 A 中添加更多水时，将增加水系统中的静压力。
The voltage in a circuit can be increased by increasing the positive charges in the terminal positive.
可以通过增加正端子中的正电荷来增加电路中的电压。
The voltage in between the conductor can be measured using the voltmeter. That connected in parallel to the conductor.
导体之间的电压可以使用电压表来进行测量。在测量时，电压表必须并联地连接于导体。
Here is a question, what happens if the voltmeter connected in series to the conductor?
这里有一个问题，如果电压表与导体串联会发生什么呢？
If the voltmeter connected in series to the conductor, the voltmeter reading becomes zero. Because, if the voltmeter connected in series to the conductor,The voltmeter is about measure the potential different in single point instead of two points. And, since voltmeter is with very high resistance, current will drop to zero in the circuit.
如果电压表与导体串联的链接，电压表读数会变为零。因为如果电压表串联在导体上，电压表将测量单点的电位差，而不是两点的电位差。由于电压表的电阻很高，电路中的电流将降至零。
The SI unit for voltage is volt, and character big caps V is used to represent the unit.
电压的 SI 单位是伏特，并且会使用大写字母 V 来表示。
This topic, we talk about electric current.
这个主题，我们谈论电流。
When an electric potential difference,is applied between two points in a circuit. The electric charges flow from higher potential point to the lower potential point. For example, point 1 and point 2 in the circuit. At which, point 1 has at higher potential, and point 2, has lower potential. The higher potential point is represented by a longer bar. The lower potential point is represented by a shorter bar. Potential difference is equal to the potential in point 1, minus with the potential in point 2. The electric charges flow from point 1 to point 2. If V1 is equal to V2, it means V is equal to zero, and there are no potential difference. And no electric current occur.
在电路的两点之间施加电位差时。 电荷会从高电位点流向低电位点。例如，电路中的电一和点二，在此，点一的电位较高，而在点二的电位较低。较高电位的点由较长的条形表示，较低电位的点由较短的条形表示。电位差等于点一的电位减去点二的电位。电荷从点一流向点二。 如果VE等于V2,则电位差等于0,因此,没有电位差。结果是,没有电流发生。Analogy
to this electric current is, when there is a net pressure difference in the water system between tank A and tank B, the water flow from a higher pressure to a lower pressure tank from tank A to tank B. When the water pressure in tank A and tank B are unequal, the pressure difference in the water system is equal to zero, and no water flow will occur. The conclusion is, electric current in a circuit is due to potential difference. And the water flow in a water system is due to the water pressure.
电流的类比是，当水箱A和水箱B之间的水系统存在着静压差时，水从高压流到低压水箱。 既是从水箱A到水箱B，当水箱A和水箱B中的水压相等时，水系统中的压力差等于零，并且不会发生水流。结论是，电路中的电流是由于电位差引起的，而水系统中的水流是由水压引起的。Electric
current is the rate of electric charges pass through a point. The rate of electrical charges pass through a point is referring to the amount of charges that move through a point within 1 second. If the charges are not in moving, it means there are no current is flowing in the circuit.
电流是电荷通过一个点的量率。电荷通过一个点的量率是指电荷在一秒内流过一个点的数量。如果电荷不移动，这意味着
Electric current flows from the higher potential point to the lower potential point, at which positive terminal is at high potential point, and the negative terminal is at lower potential point.
电流从高电位点流向低电位点。正极端子处于高电位点。
The electrons flow from lower potential point to the higher potential point in the circuit. The flow direction of electrons is always in opposite direction of the current.
电子从电路中较低电位点流向较高电位点。电子的流动方向总是与电流相反。The
flow of electric current can be measured using the ammeter that connected in series in the circuit.
可以使用电流表串联到电路中来测量电流。What
happens if the ammeter connected in parallel to the circuit?
如果电流表与电路并联连接，会发生怎样的情况？
The internal resistance of ammeter is very small. The current of the circuit will choose to flow in the ammeter loop, and no current will flow in the main circuit loop.
电流表的内电阻很小，可忽略不计。因而，电路的电流将选择在电流表环路流动，并且在主电路中不会流过电流。
Such a phenomena, because Current will choose to flow more in the path, with small rays ends.
这种现象是因为电流会选择在电阻较小的路径中流动。
High current in the ammeter will cause the ammeter damage.
电流表中的大电流会导致电流表损坏。
The SI unit for current is ampere, and character big caps A is used to indicate the ampere.
电压的 SI 单位是安培，它以大写字母 A 来表示。
Now, we talk about resistance.
现在我们谈论电阻。
Resistance is the ability of a material to resist the flow of electric current through it.
电阻是材料抵抗电流通过的能力。
When a voltage is applied to a circuit, the current will flow in between the terminal of the circuit. And when resistance of the circuit is higher, the flow of the current will become the smaller. Such a phenomena because resistance will cause the charge move slower or lesser charges will move through it.
当向电路施加电压时，电流将在电路的端子之间流动。当电路的电阻较高时，电流将变小。这种现象是因为电阻会导致电荷移动的较慢或较少。
The analogy of the resistance is the water hose width in the water system. When the water hose width becomes smaller, water will flow in slower speed. Same amount of water will take a longer time to flow from tank A to tank B.
电阻的类比是供水系统中水管的宽度。当水管宽度变小时，水将以较慢的速度流动。等量的水从水箱 A 到水箱 B 需要更长的时间。
The resistance of a material depends on four factors.
材料的电阻取决于四个因素。
The first factor is the type of material that used to conduct electricity. From periodic table, we know that the matter in the earth can be categorized as metals, metalloids, and nonmetals. Metals have very low resistance. Metalloids have higher resistance compared to metals. Nonmetals have very high resistance.
第一个因素是用于导电的材料类型。从元素周期表中，我们知道地球上的物质可以归类为金属、准金属和非金属。金属的电阻很低。与金属相比，准金属具有更高的电阻。非金属具有很高的电阻。
In among the metals, silver has the lowest resistance.
在所有金属中，银的电阻最低。
The second factor that affects the resistance is the length of the material. When the length of the material increases, the charges require more energy to complete the path. So, the longer the material, the higher is the resistance.
影响电阻的第二个因素是材料的长度。当材料的长度增加时，电荷需要更多的能量来完成路径。因此，材料越长，电阻越高。
The third factor, the cross-section area of the material. We may take a copper cable as an example. If the cross-section area of the copper increase, more charges can pass through the cable in once. Hence, it has lower resistance. If the cross-section area of the copper decrease, less charges can pass through the cable in once. Hence, it has higher resistance.
影响电阻的第三个因素是材料的横截面积。我们可以以铜线电缆为例。如果铜线的横截面积增加，一次可以有更多电荷通过电缆。因此，它具有较低的电阻。如果铜的横截面积减小，一次可以通过电缆的电荷较少。因此，它具有更高的抵抗力。
The fourth factor is temperature. In higher temperature, the atoms gain higher kinetic energy and vibrating. More collision occur between the free charges and the captive charges. Each collision uses up some energy from the free charges. And it is the basic cause of resistance increase. In low temperature, less collision occur between the free charges and the captive charges. So, the charge is able to move faster. Hence the resistance is lower.
影响电阻的第四个因素是温度。 在更高的温度下, 原子获得更高的动能, 并振动。 自由电荷和专属电荷之间发生更多的冲撞。 每次碰撞都会消耗一些电荷的能量。 这是电阻增加的根本原因。 在低温下, 自由电荷和俘获电荷之间的碰撞较少。 所以, 电荷可以更快地转移。 因此, 电阻较低。
All materials are with electric resistance. For electricity conduction purpose. Resistance is unwanted because resistance will cause energy loss.
所有的材料都带有电阻。 为了导电的目的, 电阻是不被需要的, 因为电阻会导致能量损失。
The resistor is made to have a certain resistance and used in a circuit to control the current flow in the circuit. When a lower current is required in the circuit, the resistor with higher resistance will be installed.
电阻器具有一定的电阻。 电阻器被用于电路中以控制电路中的电流。 当电路中需要较低的电流时, 将安装更高电阻的电阻器。
There are two kinds of resistor.
电阻器有两种类型。
The first is resistor with a fixed resistance. Resistor with a fixed resistance has two terminals.
第一种是电阻固定的电阻器。 固定电阻的电阻器有两个端子。
The second kind of resistor is rheostat with adjustable resistance. Rheostat has three terminals. For it function to be adjustable, the center terminal will need to always connected to the lower potential point. In the above circuit, the net resistance is always equal to R1. When adjust the arrow to the upper side of the resistor, the net resistance will reduce. When adjust the arrow to the lower side of the resistor, the net resistance will increase.
第二种是电阻可变的电阻器，或被称为变阻器。 变阻器有三个端子。为了使电阻能可调控，中心端子必须始终连接到较低的电位点。在上述电路中，静电阻等于R1。将箭头调整到电阻器的上方时，静电阻会减小。将箭头调整到电阻器的下部时，静电阻将增加。The
S.I unit for electric resistance is ohm. With symbol omega.
电阻的SI单位为欧姆，符号为欧米茄。
Resistance of a material can be measured using the resistance meter. And only can be measured when the material is not installed into the circuit. Because if the resistance of a resistor being measured at a installed circuit, the resistance from the wire, internal resistance from the voltage source, will influence the reading, an inaccurate reading will be displayed.
电阻可以使用电阻表来测量材料的电阻, 以及它可以仅在没有将材料安装到电路中时才可进行测量, 因为如果在安装的电路上测量电阻器的电阻, 来自电线的电阻以及来自电压源的内部电阻, 将影响读数,显示出的读数将会是不正确的读数。
This new topic, we will talk about the relationship between current, voltage, and resistance. Their relationship is described by Ohm's law.
这个新主题,我们将讨论电流、电压和电阻之间的关系。它们的关系可由欧姆定律来描述。
The relation between current, voltage, and resistance can be described by Ohm's law.
电流、电压和电阻之间的关系可由欧姆定律来描述。
Ohm's law stated that the current that flows through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage that across the terminal of the conductor, with the condition that the temperature and the other's physical condition are constant. For example, the conductor here is the resistor with resistance R. The keywords about the Ohm's law are current, voltage, and directly proportional. Directly proportional is meant that the current I that flow through the conductor will increase when the voltage VR across the conductor R increase.
欧姆定律表明，流过导体的电流与导体端子两端的电压，在温度和其他物理条件不变的条件下是成正比的。例如，在此导体是电阻为 R 的电阻器。欧姆定律的关键词是电流、电压和直接成比例。直接成比例是指当横跨导体 R 的电压 VR 增加时，流过导体的电流 I 将增加。
For example, when VR change from 0 V to 1 V.
例如，当 VR 从零伏特变为一伏特时。
The current will change from 0 ampere to 1 ampere.
电流将从0安培变为1安培。
When VR change to 2 volt.
当 VR 变为2伏特时。
The current, I, will change to 2 ampere.
电流 I 将变为2安培。
In the above circuit, since the supply voltage VE is connected parallel to the resistor, the supply voltage VE will always equal to the voltage across the resistor.
在上述电路中，由于电源的电压 VE 与电阻并联连接，电源电压 VE 始终等于电阻两端的电压。
With this, we can say that when supply voltage increase, the voltage across the resistance will get increase, and the current will also increase.
这样，我们可以说，当电源电压增加时，电阻两端的电压将增加，而且电流也会增加。
When supply voltage decrease, the voltage across the resistance will get decrease, and the current will also decrease.
当电源的电压降低时，电阻两端的电压将降低，而且电流也会减少。
This relationship can be represented using I versus V graph.
这种关系可以用 I 与 V 图来表示。
From this graph, for example, when the voltage is equal to 1 V.
从该图，例如，当电压等于一伏特时。
The current is equal to 1 ampere.
电流等于1安培。
When the voltage is 2 volt.
当电压为2伏特时。
The current is equal to 2 ampere.
电流就等于2安培。
When the voltage is 3 volt.
电压为3伏特时。
The current is 3 ampere.
电流是3安培。
The slope line in the graph is the line to tell the relationship between the voltage and current. And we may use it to predict the current with any voltage applied across the resistor.
图中的斜线是要说明电压和电流之间的关系。并且我们可以使用它来预测电阻两端施加的任何电压下的电流。
For example,If the voltage is 2.5 volt,
例如，如果电压为 2.5 伏特。
Through the graph, we may do a prediction, the current is 2.5 ampere.
通过图，我们可以做一个预测，电流是 2.5 安培。
The slope line in the graph has provided an important information.
图中的斜线提供了重要的信息。
It is resistance of the resistor.The resistance is the voltage, divided by the current flow across the resistor. It is 2.5 volt, divided by 2.5 ampere, and it is equal to 1 ohm.
斜线的斜度是电阻器的电阻。电阻是电压除以流经电阻的电流。它是 2.5 伏特除以 2.5 安培，这等于1欧姆。
Or, you may try to use other value to calculate the resistance. For example, 3 volt divided by 3 ampere, 2 volt divided by 2 ampere, and 1 volt divided by 1 ampere, all this are equal to value 1 ohm.
或者您可以尝试使用其他值来计算电阻。例如3伏特除以3安培、2伏特除以2安培和1伏特除以1安培，所有这些都等于1欧姆。
Please bear in mind that the Ohm's law is with conditions. The condition is temperature and the other's physical condition are constant. Constant is meant to remain unchanged and temperature need to be remained unchanged and because temperature is the factor that will affect the resistance of the conductor. The other's physical condition is referring to its length and cross-section area.
请记住，欧姆定律是有条件的。条件是温度和其他物理条件是恒定的。恒定是指保持不变。温度必须保持不变。因为温度它是会影响导体的电阻因素。其他物理状况是指它的长度和横截面积。
These are the factors that affect the resistance.
这是影响电阻的因素。
Ohm's law can be represented using the equation or formula.
欧姆定律可用等式或公式来表示。
It is V equal to I times R.
这是 V 等于 I 乘以 R.
Please remember, this equation is with condition.
请记住，这个方程是有条件的。
And with the condition, the resistance value of the resistor is a fixed value.
在该条件下，电阻器的电阻值为固定值。
Since R remained constant,Whenever the voltage across the R increase, it will cause the increment of the current. This relationship is called directly proportional.
由于 R 保持不变，只要 R 两端的电压增加，就会导致电流增加。该关系被称为直接比例。
With the Ohm's law equation, the following problem can be solved.
利用欧姆定律方程可以解决以下问题。
To determine voltage, V, if the current and resistance are given, we may use formula V equal to I times R.
如果在给定的电流和电阻下，电压 V 就可以被确定。我们可以使用公式 V 等于 I 乘以 R 来完成这个计算。
For example,If the current across the resistor is 5 ampere, and the resistance of the resistor is 2 ohm, calculate the voltage across the resistor.
例如，如果电阻上的电流为5安培，并且电阻器的电阻为2欧姆，计算电阻两端的电压。
To calculate the voltage across the resistor, we use formula V equal to IR.
为了计算电阻两端的电压，我们可使用公式 V 等于 I 乘以 R.
It is 5 ampere times 2 ohm, and it is equal to 10 volt.
这就相当于5安培乘以2欧姆，这就等于10伏特。
The second problem, determine I if the voltage and resistance are given.
第二个问题，如果给出了电压和电阻来确定电流 I.
Please take note of the equation, the equal mark. This equal mark indicates that.
请注意等式等号。这个等号表示
The component at the left-hand side is equal to the component at the right-hand side. It meant that when I do an arithmetic operation, for example, plus, minus, multiplication, or division,at the left-hand side. The same operation must apply to the component at the right-hand side.
左侧的分量等于右侧的分量。这意味着，当我在左侧进行算术运算，例如加、减、乘、除时，必须对右侧的组件执行相同的运算。
For example, when the component at the right-hand side, divided by R. At the same time, the component at the left-hand side, must also divided by R.
例如，当右侧的分量除以二时，同时，左侧的分量也必须除以 R。
Now, let's focus the right-hand side. When R, divided by R, it is equal to 1. Because, a number divided by itself, is always equal to 1.
现在，让我们专注于右侧。当右侧的 R 除以2时，它会等于 1. 因为，一个数本身的相除总是等于 1.
For example, 5 divided by 5 is 1.
例如, 5除以5为 1.
Hence, we may eliminate the R at denominator and numerator. At the right-hand side component of the equation.
因此,在等式的右侧部分,我们可以消除分母和分子的 R.
The final equation become I equal to V divided by R.
最终的方程变为 I 等于 V 除以 R.
Let's go back to the Ohm's law equation again. From the rule of mathematics, this is the mathematic rule of the algebra.
让我们再次回到欧姆定律方程。从数学法则，这就是代数的数学法则。
According to the rule, if you want to determine the I in the equation,
根据规则如果要确定方程式中的 I,
we transfer the I multiplier, R, to be the denominator of opposite side component, V.
就将 I 的倍数 R 转换为等号对面组件 V 的分母。
We get I equal to the V divided by R. Now, we know that current is equal to voltage divided by resistance. Let's proceed to an example of the problem.
因此，我们得到的 I 等于 V 除以分母 R。现在，我们知道电流等于电压除以电阻。让我们再看看一个问题的例子。
This is the example of the question. If the voltage across the resistor with resistance of 2 ohm is 10 volt, calculate the current in the circuit.
这是问题的例子。如果电阻二欧姆的电阻器两端的电压为十伏特，计算电路中的电流。
We may use the formula I equal to the V divided by R.
我们可以使用公式 I 等于 V 除以 R.
It is equal to 10 volt divided by 2 ohm.
这就相等于十伏特除以二欧姆。
The current is 5 ampere.
得到的电流是5安培。
The third problem is, determine R, if the voltage and current are given.
第三个问题是,如果给出电压和电流来确定 R。
If you want to determine R in the equation.
如果要确定方程式中的 R。
Transfer its multiplier to be the denominator at the opposite side component.
我们就将 R 的倍数 I 转换为等号对面组件 V 的分母。
We get R equal to the V divided by I.
我们就得到 R 等于 V 除以 I.
From this, we know that the resistance of a load is equal to the voltage across the load divided by the current.
由此，我们知道负载的电阻等于负载两端的电压除以电流。
Let's proceed to an example of the problem.
让我们来看一个问题的例子。
If the voltage across the resistor is 6 volt, and the current flow through the resistor is 2 ampere.
如果一个电阻两端的电压为6伏特,而流经该电阻的电流为2安培。
For the solution, we may use the formula R equal to V divided by I.
对于解决该问题，我们可使用公式 R 等于 V 除以 I
R equal to 6 volt divided by 2 ampere
R 等于6伏特除以2安培
It is 3 ohm
这是3欧姆